is it, Lizzie?
Oh, I'm so hot. I can't breathe. I feel so weak.
Oh, it's just the fever, Lizzie. It'll come down soon. I'll give you another injection. That should help.
The last one didn't do much good.
These things take time, Mrs. Randall.
Oh, really? Well, you're not pumping me with anything. You haven't got a clue what you're doing. I could cure us both while you're still doing your ridiculous tests.
I don't think that's very likely, Mrs. Randall.
Oh, really? You let me get back to my cell and I'll show you.
This is a hospital, not a witch doctor's tent. Now, if you've got any sense at all, you'll let me give you another injection.
No.
If you don't, you could die.
Then I'll die. Wonder if they'll stick you in here for losing a patient.
The only reason you'll die is because of your own stupidity. Besides, I have a witness to the fact that you're refusing treatment.
That is, if you don't kill her, too.
I'm going to report this to the doctor.
I reckon you're crazy, Ev. I'd let her do anything to me if it didn't make me better. It's a big if, Lizzie.
Come on, Hamilton. Collect your things. You're being moved back in with the others.
About bloody time. How come Mrs. Davidson changed her mind? Was she afraid I might write something about her when I got out?
The way things are going, you may never get out to write anything.
What do you mean?
You'll find out. Now hurry up.
Hey, what's going on, Vera?
What do you think's going on? Hamilton's being moved back in with the rest of you.
So why are we locked in here? We're in quarantine or something.
That's right.
Quarantine? Oh, is someone sick?
What is it? Is it serious?
Lizzie might die. Is that serious enough for you?
Get inside.
I'm not going in there.
I haven't got all day to mess around with you. Get inside.
No, I will not, and you can't make me. If I go in there, I'll get sick. No, I want to go back to isolation.
Well, isn't that just too bad? Now, come on.
No! Just let go of me. You're deliberately trying to make me get sick. Look, Vera, I won't write anything about you in the papers. I promise. Now, please take me back to isolation.
What's the matter, Sandy? Aren't we good enough for you?
Yeah, our germs are just as good as anybody else.
Now, get inside!
Come on, it's brave.
Get inside! Will you shut up?
Oh, I'm sorry, Vera. Listen, do you want a hand?
That's enough of that.
Just trying to help.
Hey, Doreen, pick up her gear.
Yeah, babe.
Who's she sharing with, anyway? You and Burns.
Oh. Well, now, isn't that nice?
You're no worse off in here than you were in isolation. Birdsworth's been bringing you your food for days. If you were going to catch anything from her, you'd have got it by now.
Mind you, that is her bed you're sitting on. It's probably loaded with germs.
That's enough of that. We're all in the same situation and nobody gets out of here until this is all over.
And when we do, it'll probably be in a box.
Oh, dear. Hey, Doreen, give Sandy your stuff.
Yeah, sure. Here you are, Sandra.
It'll be full of germs by now.
Now, is that any way to treat Doreen when she's trying to be polite?
That's how we're surviving here, you know, by helping one another.
Yeah, I thought you wanted to know what life was really like inside.
Oh, she's finding out.
She's finding out the screws can do anything they like lock you in and expose you to germs.
You know something? You'll be able to write a really good story when you get out of here.
Yeah.
It's if you live long enough.
What's going on in here?
Oh, we're just welcoming our new cellmate, Mr. Fletcher.
You all right, Hamilton?
What do you care? You're going to kill me one way or the other.
Well, she's frightened of getting sick and dying.
Yeah, that's something we all have to live with, Smith. Bryant, you follow me. The rest of you that don't belong in here, outside.
Fun playing God, isn't it? Not too good when you're on the other side, though, huh? Oh, I'll pick up the things and give them to her, Doreen.
Baxter? What? You know Baxter, don't you, Bryant? We should be sharing your cell with you. Now, we chose Bryant because she's bigger than you are. So don't try anything. It'll be lights out in a minute.
You don't want to pay any attention to him, love. He just said that to scare you.
I ain't scared.
Not even at getting sick?
I never get sick.
Yeah, that's what I used to say. Then one day, pow. Now, I am a bionic woman. the truth. I got a pacemaker in here. I'm nuclear powered.
Go on, will you? Think I am stupid?
No, you want to see? I'll show you the scar.
Nah. What's it like having a pacemaker?
Well, I can tell you one thing. It's better than not having one. Sometimes when I lie in bed at night, you know, in a funny position, I can feel it. But otherwise, it gives me no trouble. I can do most things. Want some coffee?
Nah. I wouldn't mind a biscuit, but...
Oh, sure, love. Help yourself. Take two if you like.
Thanks. Want a cup, V?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, love.
What about you?
No.
What's it to you?
Doreen has to pay for that coffee. 2 days' work for one lousy tin.
Well, you're drinking it.
And tomorrow she'll be drinking mine. Now, have you got any?
No, I haven't.
Well, then there's something else you've learned about being in prison. If you ain't got nothing, no one is going to give you nothing.
Here, B.
Thanks, love. Oh, that tastes good.
Look, will you just lay off? You've had your fun. So you know that I'm frightened of being sick. Well, so what?
We're all afraid of being sick.
Yeah, well, not like I am.
Oh?
Look, I nursed my mother when she was ill. I just had to sit there and watch her waste away in front of my eyes. There was nothing I could do for her. There was nothing anyone could do. I had to sit and watch her suffer and then die.
What'd she die of?
Cancer.
Getting along in here all right?
Well, yes, Vera, as a matter of fact, we are. I'm sorry to disappoint you.
Lights up in 5 minutes. Lights up in 5 minutes. Lights up in 5 minutes.
Don't you have any pajamas?
What?
Don't you have pajamas?
Nah.
Oh, well, I'll get you some.
Yeah, where? Can I have another biscuit?
Oh, sure, I'll help yourself.
Is that how you buy them, Bryant? With biscuits?
Yeah, that's right, Vera. You want a nibble?
You're disgusting.
Who are you calling disgusting?
Oh, don't pay any attention.
You want to see something disgusting? I'll show you. I'll bash your head.
Lesbian.
What's the matter? Get it on face, me.
Vera.
Show that rotten bitch. See her face?
Nice sharing with you. Gets you lonely at night sometimes.
Yeah, I know.
Good night.
Good night, Georgie.
I said good night.
Good night.
Are you all right?
Oh, yes, it's this epidemic. It's making me a bit jumpy, that's all. How are the rounds?
Oh, marvellous. Baxter's getting along famously with Bryant.
Oh, good.
Good. She was just dancing around half naked in front of her.
Oh, you can't change the way people are, Vera.
It's disgusting.
Probably. There's a nightdress and dressing gown for you on the bed.
Well, where did these come from?
They're prison issue. It's the last they had.
Are yours prison issue?
No. Bob dropped a couple of them in for me at the gate.
Must be nice to have someone to drop things in. He could have got something for me.
How would he have got into your flat? The doctor wouldn't have let you send the key out.
He could have asked the landlord.
Oh, Vera, for heaven's sake. I don't want to argue with you.
I'm sorry, it's just that I'm a bit tense. I don't feel very well, actually.
You're not sick, are you?
Oh, I'm just a bit on edge, I think.
You've got a temperature. I'll call the doctor.
Look, I'm fine. He's got enough to do.
He said that if any of us were feeling the slightest bit strange, we should call him. Now, you wait here.
Well?
The same symptoms, I'm afraid. In fact, her temperature's even higher than the other two. I can't understand it. She's